As you are already well aware, medical school in the United States is ridiculously expensive. The average cost is $60,000 per year for public medical schools, and even higher for private medical schools. The average debt for medical students graduating in 2017 was close to $200,000. I was fortunate enough to graduate with actually very little debt. I'll show you how to do the same. What's going on, guys? Dr. Jubal, MedSchoolInsiders.com. Quick shout out to the Patreon supporters that voted for me to make this video. If you want to vote for upcoming video topics and get a bunch of other perks, visit the Med School Insiders Patreon page, link in the description below. Now, the funds to pay for medical school will come from one of three sources: you and your family's pockets, loans, and scholarships or grants. You want to minimize the first two and maximize the latter, which is free money. Let's go over each one. First, most medical schools will ask for your and your parents' financial information. Even if your parents are not going to contribute a dime to your medical education, schools often require their tax information in determining who they should offer financial aid to. Remember, your parents are not required to contribute to your medical school education expenses, so be very grateful if they contribute at all. My parents were not able to contribute to my college or medical school costs, but I was still able to become a doctor with very little debt in the end. We'll get to how I managed to do that shortly. Next, loans. There are three main categories of loans: federal, school, and private. Federal and school loans generally have more favorable terms, such as longer periods of deferment and lower interest rates. Private loans have some of the worst terms and should be avoided. Only sign private loans when absolutely necessary. When you start medical school, you'll be served with a financial aid package which will summarize your school's offerings for federal and school loans, grants, and scholarships. It's important to create a realistic budget for yourself and only take out the loans for the amount of money that you actually need. You'll be paying interest on every dollar you take out. Again, only take the amount you actually need. I initially was planning on giving you a detailed summary of each type of loan and the optimal strategy in signing up for loans to minimize your long-term cost and interest. However, I wasn't able to fit all of that in this video. If you would like me to cover these topics in a future video, leave a comment down below so that I can gauge interest. Now, with recent changes in the education budget on a national level, federal loans are not nearly as favorable as they were a few years ago. However, some subsidized school loans will not accrue any interest for the period of medical school and sometimes even through residency. That's right, you don't even have to pay back for inflation. These are awesome loans, so if you are offered them, I definitely recommend taking them. Private loans generally have the highest interest rates and are not included in most forgiveness programs. Loan forgiveness programs are a popular way to reduce your overall loan burden. They are most advantageous for students with significant debt. The way it works is simple. You work for an organization, employer, or program for a set period of time, and in return, you receive either partial or complete loan forgiveness or loan repayment. The Department of Education's Public Service Loan Forgiveness Program offers loan forgiveness for working in the government or nonprofit organizations. After making 10 years of monthly payments, the remaining loan balance is forgiven. The National Health Service Corps offers a loan repayment program for those in primary care specialties practicing in underserved areas. There are also a few options through the military. Now, onto the fun part: free money. The main reason I was able to graduate with such a little debt is through obtaining scholarships and grants. When you first get accepted to medical school, I recommend reaching out to the financial aid office, even before classes start, and asking them about what scholarships or grants are offered. Most medical schools keep a list of annual scholarships and grants, many of which you may be eligible for. Awards are not just for good grades. Eligibility criteria widely varies. Some may be specific to a certain background or ethnicity, specialty or practice type, religion, hometown or place of birth, etc. In addition to reaching out to your school's financial aid office, definitely search online for medical student grant and scholarship offerings. I have links to websites and resources I personally found useful down in the description below. Now, the juicy part. Here's a little known secret that can make the difference of hundreds of thousands of dollars. If you get accepted to multiple medical schools, let them incentivize you to come to their school over others with scholarship offers. Obviously, you need to be accepted to more than just one medical school. Simply send an email to the admissions office, explain you are interested in their program but are weighing other acceptances as well. Ask if there are any scholarships or grants that they can offer to reduce your out-of-pocket cost. After sending out these emails to the schools that I was accepted to and interested in, I was able to get almost all of my medical school paid for. Had I not sent out those emails, I may have been in hundreds of thousands of dollars in debt. Now, I'm going to say this not to toot my own horn, but for full transparency. I was a highly competitive medical school applicant, obtaining interview offers at the majority of the medical schools I applied to, interviewing at most of the top medical schools, including 3 out of the top 4, and gaining acceptances to several. Ultimately, I went to a program I was excited about because of its location, the people, and the culture. And did I mention the location? They also offered me their highest merit-based scholarship, and I only took small loans to cover a portion of my living expenses. Many of the largest scholarships, like the one that I received, are merit-based and are offered to students with stellar medical school applications. This means having a top MCAT, GPA, research, and being well-rounded with impressive extracurriculars. A compelling personal statement and crushing it on interview day with refined interview skills are also essential. You have to be a beast of an applicant, and I want to help you be that stellar applicant. Now, while it's impossible to guarantee merit-based scholarships, multiple advisors on MedSchoolInsiders.com also earned sizable or even full-ride scholarships to medical school. These are real doctors who were top performers. At MedSchool Insiders, we don't settle for anything less. We can show you exactly how we did it and teach you from our own firsthand experience of success. If you want to be a stellar applicant and receive one-on-one advising, tutoring, interview preparation, personal statement or secondary editing, mentorship, or any of the other services we offer, visit MedSchoolInsiders.com. Our services will help you become a much stronger applicant, which increases the chance that you too will receive scholarships, and that means saving a lot of money. Talk about a good investment. Check out these emails I recently received from YouTube subscribers. They were fans who watched the channel, who went to the website and purchased services. The reason they're so happy is because of our results. We're different from any other med school admissions consulting company for 2 reasons. First, our advisors are all real doctors who have performed exceptionally in their field. And second, unlike any other company, we have a proprietary systematic methodology that ensures the best possible results. We align your goals and interests with those of our advisors. They don't just love mentoring and paying it forward. They're also incentivized to give you the best possible service. That's why so many of our advisors go above and beyond what they're asked for, and why our customers have been so impressed. For a limited time, use the coupon code SCHOLARSHIP15 for $15 off your purchase of $100 or more. As always, thank you all so much for watching. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to make a video going into more detail about the different types of loans or any other video requests you may have. If you know someone else going to medical school and you want them to have less than $200,000 of debt, please share this video with them. If you liked the video, make sure you press that like button, hit subscribe if you have not already, and I will see you guys in that next one.